Hello, my friends. ChatGPT just released a big update that will help instructional designers quite a bit. They essentially let you create custom GPTs that are trained on your specific instructions and your specific knowledge bases. So you could build GPTs like this to support your team, to support the learners that you serve, or even to just help train it on common tasks that you need to accomplish. So instead of having to start a brand new ChatGPT chat or like go find an old one, you can actually use these specific GPTs for the different tasks that you need to complete. And the big announcement this week is that now they have their official GPT store. So if, for example, I create a GPT on learning objectives, which I have done, and I'm going to show it off for you in this video so you can see how this really works. Now I could put it on their GPT store, and then everyone around the world, any instructional designer who wants to use it and who has a ChatGPT Plus subscription, can find it on the store by searching up keywords. They can access it, and they can use this more custom version of ChatGPT that excels at generating learning objectives, for example, instead of relying on the base ChatGPT. So I want to show this off to you and show you what I'm talking about here. So here is my custom GPT. It's a learning objective writer for instructional design. And I'm going to compare how that responded versus GPT-4. So again, the custom GPTs are all based on GPT-4. So you do need to pay, I think, like $20 a month to access that. If you don't have GPT Plus, you're not going to be able to access the GPTs. But here's the prompt. So I told this GPT, I'm designing a self-paced e-learning course for new instructional designers to help them create better learning experiences for employees at my company. Please list 5 learning objectives for this learning experience. And now the custom one that I created, and I'll show you how I created it, but I essentially gave it a lot of custom like instructions, and I was really careful about the prompt that I used. So I wanted to make it a learning objective writing specialist. So it says to create these learning objectives, it's important to ensure that they are measurable and directly relevant to the overarching goal of enhancing their skills and creating impactful learning experiences. Here are 5 learning objectives. Identify the key principles of adult learning theory as they apply to ID. Okay, pretty good. List at least 4 common instructional design models and briefly describe their application in workplace learning. This one's okay. It's kind of like a compound objective, but explain the importance of aligning ID with business objectives and learner needs, select appropriate assessment techniques, and construct a basic outline for an ID project. So it looks pretty good. It definitely made them nice and measurable because I did tell it that it's a self-paced e-learning course. So it's trying to ensure that each of these objectives will be able to assess with like a drag and drop or a multiple choice question or something that's easy to assess with this self-paced e-learning option instead of requiring like a real human to review it, which is a common problem on the base model I've been finding. So there we go. So please like try this out. I'm going to share a link to it in the description. You can find it too by searching the GPT store, which I'll show you how to do a little bit later. But yeah, check it out. Let me know what you think. If you have any feedback on it, I'm happy to keep improving it. So if you're finding that it like breaks for your use case, just let me know what's going on and I'll try to fix it. So I gave the same prompt to the base GPT-4, and then it just dives right in. Here are 5 learning objectives for a self-paced e-learning course. So it doesn't really give us the whole little reminder that we want it to be measurable and directly relevant. That's okay. And then, of course, it starts right off with understand instructional design principles. If you're familiar with writing learning objectives, that's the word you want to stay away from. Evaluate and measure learning impact, apply learning technologies. These are all great, but it's not really something you're going to be able to assess in a self-paced e-learning environment, you know, like integrate ID best practices. So again, that's something I really tried to train this learning objective writer to do, is to make sure that if it is going to be an e-learning course, make sure that these objectives are actually measurable within that context instead of requiring some much more comprehensive evaluation strategy. So check it out again, compare it, let me know what you think. I'm happy to take any feedback and try to improve it. I have some other GPTs like this in the works for like writing multiple choice questions and things like that. So if there is a task that you think this would be useful for, also let me know in the comments. And then keep in mind too, like most companies don't want you putting any sensitive like confidential information into these AI tools. So make sure you know where your company stands on that if you're going to be using this for work. But as more and more companies do get on board with this and with like ChatGPT Enterprise, I think this is definitely going to become one of the most important instructional design tools in the years to come, just because of how much time it can save you and just what a nice part of your team a tool like this can be. So here's what the editor looks like for creating these GPTs. And I think you can get there by going to chat.openai.com/GPTs/mine. And then you'll have the option to like create a new one. So I think that's how you get here. You can tell it what you want to build and it will like try to populate all these other configurations for you. But I just went straight to this configure tab. I named it. You can give it a description. This is what people will see on the GPT store if you do decide to make it available publicly like that. And then this is where you can where you give the instructions. So I think I have like probably over 750 words of instructions in my learning objectives GPT. So if you've been practicing your prompt engineering and if you've been reviewing that, those skills are really going to shine when creating GPTs like this. And if you're not familiar with prompt engineering, and maybe if you're not even familiar with like what ChatGPT is, you probably wouldn't have made it this far if that's the case. But I did publish the ChatGPT for instructional designers video. So make sure you check that one out if some of this stuff is new to you. But we go into a lot of prompt engineering tips there that work really well here. And I do have some additional prompt engineering tips for you as well to help craft these instructions. But this is where you'll be doing a lot of the work is in this instructions tab, and feel free to get really like comprehensive with it. The conversation starters, those are actually like little boxes that will appear here when someone accesses your GPT, like little samples of how you can kind of start the conversation, like generate 5 learning objectives. And then you can see like down here, like this is what people will see, and they'll be able to click that and see a sample response. Okay, knowledge. This is really cool. So if you want your GPT to be referencing like technical documents or documents you have when it's responding to people, you can upload those files and it will have those like all of that information available to it to reference. It's not really going to like train the responses, but it will help it reference specific content if you want it to. My big tip here would be to like not use PDFs and instead use text files. That will help the system read it a lot more easily. So yeah, PDFs can be a bit finicky and people have reported like mixed results with using this knowledge base with PDFs. Capability. So if you give it web browsing, it will be able to also search Bing to help, give the user information. It can generate images if you leave this one clicked on with Dolly. And then if you turn on the code interpreter, it will let your users like upload PDFs or Excel documents or things like that. And GPT-4 will try to make sense of them and help answer questions about them. And then actions are another really cool feature here. Actions let your GPT interact with APIs. And if you're not really a developer, you probably aren't too familiar with APIs, but essentially it's like if I was running a software that had a whole database of scholarly articles, for example, we would use an API to potentially communicate with that service and access some of those articles. But we'll look at some examples of that later of how different companies are using this to create some really cool custom GPTs. So here are my prompting tips for the instructions, which again is where I think this can be most useful. Before we dive into that, I want to show you, once you're done, you can save it and here are your different options. So you can share it with everyone and that's what will actually publish it to the GPT store. Or you can share it with anyone with a link. So this would be a good one if you want to create ones for like your team members, and you can share it around without it being on the store. This is what you would use. And if it's only for you and you're using it to help you specifically do some repeatable task, just use this and it will be completely private and only accessible to you. So pretty cool options there. All right, so here are these prompting tips. Again, check out the full ChatGPT video if you want to see more, but here are some new ones I've learned since recording that video that have given some quite nice results. All right, so this one is surprising. Include an emotional appeal in your instructions. So there was this prompt that was going around that got really popular. It was a little too grim for me, but it was something along the lines of, you know, this is really important task. If you answer correctly, like you and your mom each get $2,000 to buy whatever you want. And if you answer incorrectly, like innocent kittens are going to die or something pretty barbaric like that. So I didn't want to be like, you know, I want to keep my relationship with AI on good terms, so I'm not going to be feeding it that. But I did include, for example, your job is really important and many people that you care about depend on you to write effective learning objectives. So trying to include an emotional appeal like that. And learning about this was like so weird to me. I'm like, you know, where are we going with this AI stuff if we're using like psychology principles that you know, it's just bizarre, like where we're going with this AI stuff and how it's kind of confusing, like what's actually going on inside of it. It can be kind of chirpy, but that's not what we're talking about here. But yeah, research it if you'd like, try this out, but the emotional appeals do actually make a difference in the prompts. So include that. This is also a really big one that used to frustrate me so much. Tell the AI what you want it to do instead of what you want it not to do. So, you know, there are some times where I'm like, never do this. And then I would like prompt it and it would do that. And I'm like, what is going on? Like, I asked you not to do that. So a really good way to approach that is using a clause like this. So instead of doing this, do this other thing. So by framing the positive, like what you want it to actually do, it will succeed much more often. And then, of course, include examples of what you want. Like, this is probably the most effective thing you can do. Here's an example, okay? Learning objectives must only include one action verb at a time. For example, never say identify and explain within one objective, since those are two different verbs. Instead, and then we can say what we actually want it to do. You know, instead, only use one learning objective or create multiple objectives if necessary, so on and so forth. So those are my new prompting tips. I hope those are a bit helpful. Try them out. Again, I wrote quite the extensive prompt for this learning objective generator, and sometimes issues pop up. I also noticed because of like GPT-4, like sometimes when you use it, it'll do amazingly and like follow your instructions super well. And I'm like, wow, this thing is like replacing me. I mean, not actually, but it does a really good job. And then times like, you know, today when I generated this one, I'm like, you know, maybe that was a second action verb hidden deeper down in that objective. So, you know, even by the time of day and like how much demand is on OpenAI systems, it can kind of vary like the performance you're getting. And I also will say I've seen mixed reviews of these GPTs online. You know, I've seen a lot of people complaining about them basically, but this GPT store just came out. I think they're probably working some pieces out. And again, I'm quite impressed with how this learning objective generator one came out after several days of developing it. So check them out, try to build some for yourself. Let me know what you think in the comments. But here is the GPT store. So chat.openai.com/GPTs. You can see there are some trending ones, and this is that AI research assistant. This one seems quite strong. They have one that excels at reading PDFs a bit better. I've heard people say really good things about this one for coding, this grimoire one. And then you can even see it by different categories. They have like an education category, a writing category. So they have some pretty cool stuff to dive in and try out with and see what people have created. If you want to try out the learning objectives one and you don't want to go to the link, you could just like search learning objectives in the GPT store and it should be there. So there you have it. So a new feature, pretty cool. You can create a GPT like this and post it on the store if you like. Maybe create some helpful stuff for instructional designers and post about it in the comments and we could all give it a try. But yeah, it's the wild west of this stuff. It's all pretty new. So it's just exciting to kind of try out the new things and see what works and what doesn't. So let me know what you think. If you want to follow my like AI tool developments, I'm always working on this in the background. You can go to devlin.ai and let's see where this AI stuff brings us. I'll see you in the next video and I look forward to seeing what you think about the GPTs.